The recording has started. Q&A session has started. To ask your question, please press star 6.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. To God be the absolute glory. Who know that God has a plan? Not just a plan for me, but he got a plan for you. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And we bless God that he has a plan for you and for I. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. And we are absolutely excited about the plan that God has for us. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. Glory, 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 glory be unto God in this place. We was just listening to, amen, God has a plan by none other than gospel recording artist Willie Sherman. And we just bless God for the anointed man of God. I'm telling you, God has a plan. And even in the plan, it has brought us down into the 6 o'clock hour on this day. Amen. And we bless God for the plan that he has for you and I. I want to welcome each and every last one of you to the In the Church TV and radio broadcast. I am your host, Apostle Deron Shay Zorn, with Divine Order Restoration Ministries International, where we are restoring the order of God, one life, one body, one nation at a time. We all know that in the church, we are shining the light of God's word in the church to discuss and resolve real everyday issues that are taking place around the world to expose, amen, exposing the good, the bad, and the ugly. Just engaging in very powerful conversations, amen, with our opinions, expertise, and surely, amen, the truth of God's word on every topic imaginable. This month, in the month of June, this month, amen, we are in our Men of Faith series, and we're just having a ball with the Lord and everybody that he's sending by, dropping by in the church, and just men of power, men of faith, amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus, who just been anointed and appointed for such a time as this. And on tonight, we have a very special, amazing studio guest, amen, with us, who is just going to, amen, allow the Spirit of the Lord to just use him mightily. Tonight, our topic is God has a plan. Now, if you know anybody, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, I want you to go ahead and just share this broadcast right here on your social media platforms. You may want to email it out, text the link out, email the link out to all that you know, so that they can come into this powerful conversation about God and his plans, right? Here today, and even as we talk to our special guest, as he has surely, amen, put together an amazing project that is centered all around that particular, amen, that particular statement. And so we're going to learn all about it tonight, in addition, which is going to engage, amen, how the Spirit of the Lord moves us. You guys know how we do it here in the church. We need to, amen, let us go to the throne of grace. And after we come back from the throne of grace, I'm going to introduce to you this amazing, 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 dynamic man of God. Oh, gracious Lord, we just bless you for meeting and greeting us in the church on tonight. We thank you, Lord, in the majestic name of Jesus, that you will come in this place and saturate the atmosphere and saturate the network system, oh God, and the airways. And even, oh God, as we begin to engage in conversation, as we commit this broadcast into your hands, that you would do, oh God, whatever it is that you have ordained in the heavenly places to be released in the hearts and the minds of your people, that words of penetration and activation will begin to go through the airways, oh God, and touch the hearts and the minds of mankind, so that they, oh God, hallelujah, will hear from you and their whole atmosphere will begin to change as their mind is transformed and renewed in your very truth. Oh gracious, oh mighty, oh holy one of Israel, we thank you in this place and how you're going to touch the lives of your people, God, as you use us in this place. We thank you for the plan that you have declared for each and every last one of our lives, that plan to prosper and not to be harmed, that plan of a future and hope in you, O gracious King. Have your way in the church on tonight as we decrease so that you may increase. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. To God be the glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My God, I'm getting ready to introduce this amazing, powerful man of God. I do want you guys to know, as always, as we're engaging in conversation, you can always call in with any questions, comments, or prayer requests that you may have at 563-999-1824. Amen. That is 563-999-1824. And we'll surely, amen, engage with you in your questions, comments, as well as your prayer requests as well. For those that are out on a few of our social media platforms, if you're on the website in the church, or if you are on the Spreaker platform or on the Facebook, on our Facebook page, know that you can make your comments, you put your prayer requests right there in under the broadcast, and we will take care of those for you live on the air. Amen. In the name of Jesus, glory, glory, glory be unto God in this place. So let us just get down to, amen, you knowing this powerful and very anointed man of God that's getting ready to just bless each and every last one of you on tonight. Just going to bless the In the Church family. And so let me go ahead and introduce who this special guest is for tonight. He is a Christian and gospel recording artist, music producer, and songwriter. He has completed his new single, God Has a Plan. The song is a message of encouragement to individuals struggling with depression and adversity. The song is about people that are in a point in their lives of depression and just seeking another way, and to give them the knowledge that will help them with whatever they're experiencing at this particular time. What he talks about in the song is what you can do to overcome adversity. And there is another day, and there is another way out of whatever you're going through, says our guest. He's hailing from Augusta, Georgia. He started his humble beginning. He began studying music at the age of 10. He was inspired to become a musician, listening to genres R&B and jazz. Beginning in elementary school, he learned to play several instruments, including the drums, the trumpet, and French horn. Because he was such a talented musician, his love for musicianship transferred into the studio. And by the age of 16, he was working as a session drummer, recording drums for gospel albums. Currently, he has released several singles, including Another Day, which is distributed by LG Music Pub, and Walking in the Spirit, which is distributed by Famous Records. Both singles have experienced much success in the market, being broadcasted on over 48 commercial and transistorial radio stations in the U.S. cities that the singles were broadcasted included Flint, Michigan, Little Rock, Arkansas, Memphis, Tennessee, Jackson, Mississippi, Montgomery, Alabama, Cleveland, Ohio, New York, Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas, Kansas City, Missouri, Augusta, Georgia, Birmingham, Alabama, Baltimore, Maryland, Detroit, Michigan, Huntsville, Alabama, Columbia, South Carolina, Chicago, Illinois, Cincinnati, Ohio, Tarrant, New Jersey, and many others. We look forward, individuals are looking forward to partnering with this dynamic man of God on his new release, this new single that has been out since February. He is an artist and musician that has archived much notoriety and success throughout his career. This record, this God has a plan, amen. It's being distributed to over 200 countries worldwide. Hallelujah. Through Renita Holyfield, MBA founder and CEM of LG Music Pub, states. We want to welcome to the In the Church TV and radio broadcast none other than the minister, amen, minister, my God, Willie Sherman, who is just an amazing, dynamic man of God. Welcome to the church, Mr. Sherman. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Mr. Sherman, hallelujah. Are you with us tonight? Oh, my Lord. Bless you, Mr. Sherman. How are you? Again, welcome in the church.
Thank you. Thank you kindly for having me.
Awesome. I am just absolutely excited on tonight, Mr. Sherman, with this interview that we're getting ready to partake in, and with your the anointing that God has upon your life and your project that's been out since February, and it is just absolutely amazing. And so I want to ask you, I'm always interested in how we come up with titles for songs and, you know, ministries and things of that nature, because I understand that there's a lot that comes behind a name. And so what birthed out the title of this single, this project, God Has a Plan?
Well, for me, it was, I was in a place at the time, a season in my life where I was having a lot of struggles and negative things all around me, and I was doing what the words say do, meaning I was living according to the covenant. And I asked God, what is it that I can do to get out of this. You know, you told me that you was nigh to a broken spirit. So why do I have to continuously, you know, deal with these people in the music industry that were, you know, they was not who they say they were? And God spoke and told me that he had a plan for my life. At that time, that's what he told me. But I just kept fasting and praying and seeking whatever else that I could do with myself. He said that if I made one step, he would make two. I had been doing the recording. So in that place I was in at that time, I was very, very uncomfortable. And God gave me the song, God Has a Plan. And that song really put me in a place where I had to really meditate. And I said, Lord, is this just for me? He said, no, it's for everyone, just not only you, but it's for all the world, every nation, every language, every village. I want you to go out there to tell them about the plan that I have for their life. So that led to the song I began to write. And God Has a Plan came into, he brought it into fulfillment. And the places that I was instructed to send it out to for reviews, they wanted me to, you know, they wanted to promote and market the song. So that's what happened. And God brought me to a place to, you know, where I had the opportunity to produce and write the song and perform it. And it's now it's out there, and I'm praying and hoping God that it will bless the people that who have the ears to hear truth and want redemption and transformation in their life, so that they would do what the covenant tells us to do, so we can walk in the plan that God has for our life. Because it takes more than just, you know, singing the song. You have to also live the song. You know, we have to be a demonstration to all the world. So that's how it came about. And I try very, very diligently and very hard to stay focused on God's perfect will that he has for all of our lives, not just for myself, but all the world. He has a plan for us to do great and mighty things.
Awesome, awesome. I just absolutely love it. And so you made a statement about, you know, you said you was in a place where you was operating, living the covenant, just moving in the word of God, being an example, being a living epistle, right? But you found yourself in a place where there was adversity. And yeah. So I want to just talk about that for a moment, because, you know, many people, you know, they're in our mindset. So in the mindset of many, they just believe that, you know, in this walk and in this way, that there should not be any adversity, you know, whatsoever. And, you know, and this one scripture that they love to use to kind of, you know, back that up, that the blessings of the Lord, it make it rich and added no sorrow with it. And so they love to use that. And in a way to me, to kind of like cop out of some things. But I love what you said. You said right there, God spoke, I have a plan. So I just want to talk to the church on tonight about adversity, you know, dealing with adversity, how to handle adversity, how to go in that, how to survive in that in-between moment between hearing maybe the prophecy or the word of God for your life and obtaining that promise. Because usually in the middle of it all, there is great adversity. So let's talk about that for a moment.
Okay. Yes. In the process of the state of adversity, we must stay in God's faith so that he can empower us to, you know, walk through these things, the spirit of adversity, with our mind and our eyes looking into the hills where cometh all of our help, and that will be his word. Staying in the word, getting that which pertains to the hour that we're in so that we can stay focused on what thus says the Lord. And I learned through that I had to obey his covenant. And whatever God said, I had to keep the faith, the confidence, believe it before I can even see it, to stay focused on that word that he had given to me, how to do it and what to do. And he said that was a season and a time that he will birth his word, the promise. And I've learned through that, me now, I had to be faithful and forever true to this word. No compromising. I had to be taught how to walk in holiness and righteousness and the spirit. He said that if I walk in the spirit, I will not fulfill the lust of the flesh, but this flesh will separate you from God and you will miss your destiny. I had to be true because I was being introduced to a lot of things. You know, it didn't glorify God. It was music, but it didn't glorify God. And when I asked God what that was that I was supposed to do, he said a new song. He would give me a new song, and he did. And I promised myself, and I told God, if you can just empower me and build me up in the word and teach me, give me the wisdom, the understanding, and the knowledge of your word, and teach me how to live holy and walk in righteousness and seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and your righteousness and all things will be added unto me. I had to be taught. I had to be discipled through the word of God to get this, to apply it to my life, not just knowing the scripture, but to apply the word to my life. That's the only way for me. I believe that it worked. I had to live it. So I have to live this word. We all have to live this word when we are worshiping and praising God. He said, they that worship me must worship in spirit and in truth. But in a state of adversity, you have other voices speaking to you. I did. Somebody else, they may be all 100%. But at that particular time, before this song came to pass, I was offered a lot of other things to do that did not glorify God. So I had to be taught by God through and by way of his word to be a demonstration. And being a demonstration for God, all God Almighty, we have to walk like his only beloved son, Jesus the anointed one, who came from heaven to earth to teach us how to live in this dark, cold, rebellious world and not be a part of all the things that pull me out of the presence of God. Because in his presence, I've learned through that there is the fullness of joy, everlasting peace, and agape love that never changed. I had to get that. And the only way I got it, my brothers and sisters, I had to have an intimate relationship with the Holy God of Israel. I don't think you can walk with him in the flesh. Matter of fact, I know you can't. I thought Amen. I could. So adversity, that's a bad word when you say you're on a mission for Christ. He said this. He told me this. If you love me, you say you love me, you write love in these songs, and you don't even know love, because I didn't know what love really was before I met Christ, before I was filled with the Spirit. All the love that I was introduced to on planet Earth, it was a selfish kind of love. You know, me, myself, and I. But God exposed himself to me through and by way of his word and taught me what real love was all about. It was about other people's. It really wasn't about me. And I used to think and meditate on the scriptures, how Jesus came down from heaven to earth in a bodily form, a natural man, and walked on planet earth and did not commit one sin. And that was very difficult for me. I had to study that for a long time. How did he do that? Well, the Holy Spirit. Being filled with the Holy Spirit is your only weapon. The word of God was my only weapon, and it still is today. That's my only weapon. That's what I fight with. The most powerful weapon in all creation in the world is this word of God. And I overcame adversity and all the other T's, even including the enemy, through and by way of this word that God gave to me. He brought me out, and he kept me out. And I told him, I would, Lord, if you just teach me and show me, I will serve and worship you for the rest of my life. So this is a serious ministry for me. It's not an entertainment. It's worship and praising and helping the weak and empowering them through words and songs to be ye strong in the Lord and trust and depend on him and look, lean not to your own understanding. But I had to learn this through God to do it, because it wasn't taught to me like that. I couldn't get it like that. It just wasn't happening for me. So that's the word of God was my only solution to overcome the spirit of adversity, the state of adversity, whatever. He is the way, he is the truth, and the pathway to your destiny. Try Jesus.
Amen. I know that's right. Try Jesus. You're going to find out. You're going to taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And you won't go back. You won't go back. Amen. So you drink of this cup, you will never thirst again.
Yes. Yes.
My Lord Jesus. My. You just said so many powerful things that is like right now, you know, for the body of Christ, you know, in the midst of adversity, the body of Christ, the world, you know, where, you know, suicide is, you know, at an all-time high, depression, you know, among the people who need to know that, you know what, that yes, God has a plan, and that there is another road that you can travel to get to where it is, amen, that God has called forth in your life to fight, you know, your place of victory, that this, your current situation is not your final destination, amen. Yeah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So I was even hearing you speak, and you said so many wonderful things, and you said, look, I was in this place. And, you know, I was in the industry and I was being introduced, you know, I was being enticed, you know, introduced to so many different things that was, not of the will of God. And you had to distinguish the difference and understand that there was a difference, that what you was being exposed to or introduced to, that it wasn't in the ordinance of the word of God. And you had to make a decision that, that, you know, you wanted to stick with the winner.
Amen. Amen. I like that. Praise you, Lord. Awesome. I like that, Apostle. Wow.
Oh, my Jesus. And there's so many people who are in, you know, and just want you to minister to, you know, people who just may be in that place where, you know, where there's dire temptation that is there and that's all around them. And they're in that place and they're looking for success. And I know sometimes in just various places, you know, where the enemy will come in and, you know, just lure you little by little. And sometimes it's not little by little, it's just bam up in your face. And to see if you would take the bite because of what you're expecting or what you're looking for. And I know many people have came in various industries and definitely the music industry as well, and just have gotten has taken the bite of what the enemy has put out there and lured them into places that caused them to break the covenant with God.
Yeah.
Let's just talk about Hallelujah. That. Amen. To help somebody to come out from among them. Amen. Glory to God.
Okay, you, the Jesus. Covenant. The covenant that God gave unto man. Gave it to Moses to bring down to tell us what God wanted us to do and what we had to do to please him. So I say this to all of my brothers and sisters who may be struggling like I was once upon a time, didn't have a clue about what God wanted from me. I didn't even know him like that. I knew him by association because I was forced to go to church in my family because I came up in a Christian family, but I wasn't a Christian. And I wasn't being taught Christianity in the proper way. I wasn't being taught how to be a man. So I got this for some man listening to me needs to hear what I'm about to tell him. Because you are hungry and thirsting for something better than what you've been doing all your life, and you still in the same place. So let me give you this. I want to give this to you. This is for you. You was here today to hear what I'm about to say to you. The covenant of God is truly real. And God said every nation that does not obey his covenant shall be brought to naught. And that's what the covenant of God is. And what the covenant is what God have gave us, the commandments that he want us to live and abide by. If you want to go to the promised land, if you want to see what your destiny really, really and truly look like, I encourage you to connect with Jesus, the anointed one. Obey his covenant. Don't just hear his word, but be a doer. God is looking for a demonstration. People's going to demonstrate who he really is, not to put him to shame, but to show the world, your partners and your friend that you used to kick it with. Go show them because he wants you to go back from where he brought you and I from, to go back and to minister to your friends in whatever industry that you operate in. That's what he's doing for me. I don't speak nothing but what God puts upon my lips and has written on the tablet of my heart to say to his people. And I'm not going to do it in a very ignorant way. I have to be led by the Holy Spirit. But this is for you, my brother, my sister. When the true and living God, what God wants from believers here and now, meaning today, right now, in your neighborhood, in your city, your state, your country, what he wants from us is obedience. He wants you and I and every living mankind to obey the covenant. We were created to worship nobody but God. Nobody but God. He put us on planet Earth. He sent us here. We was birthed in sin, but he gave us a way of escape out of sin, the perfect lamb. So here and now, today, we got that. Now, how do we put all of this in action in our life to practice it and live it and demonstrate what Jesus was all about? Because he knew no sin. And he gave us the same, very same options if we come to know him personally and obey his covenant. This is what he would do. He said, if we obey his covenant, his law, that's it, that's God's law, because hypocrisy, he will never endure. As my lukewarm brothers and sisters out there say, you know, God is going to judge you and I for that. I had to get that. I had to get it. And we all as Christians must get this, the truth. We must get the word and obey the word, not just talk it, but do it. If you love him, he said, what? Keep my commandments. So if I love to tell, I go around the country telling people that I love God, I need to be a demonstration and show the world what love really is, because the world does not know love. And I will confess that myself. I never known love before the love of Christ. I have never met anybody with a love like the love of Christ. I haven't. You may have, but I haven't. Don't judge me. Everything I say, I don't have to debate with them and compromise the word of God. It's already written. It is written to be ye holy. The Apostle Peter said, God told him to tell us to be ye holy, for the Lord thy God is holy. So if you say, tell me
or your church or whomever, your group, about righteousness, you don't have to preach it to them. Show them what they what it really looks like, because they don't even understand. They don't even know what you're talking about when you start talking about the spirit realm. Unsaved man or someone that's not filled with the Holy Spirit, they don't have a clue of what you're talking about. They're going to call you all kind of names, maybe not in your face, because it happened to me and it happened to a lot of other pastors and evangelists and prophetess and prophets. It happens when you are on the straight and narrow. Don't expect to have a lot of friends. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, be not deceived by the enemy like Adam and Eve. Don't let the devil trick you out of your destiny, out of your relationship that God has predestined just for you. It was specifically, nobody can do what he have predestined you to do but you. But it's going to cause you. It will definitely cause you. It's going to cause you your mind, body, soul, will, and emotion. You got to connect with God and obey his word. You know the scripture, obedience is greater than sacrifice. If you take that for weakness, something is definitely wrong with who you're being under for your teaching, because that's not the word. Ain't no such thing as you almost saved, or if you want to be saved, if I want to be saved, I walk away from stuff I won't even discuss on this interview. But you know what? I gave it all up to live for God. I'd never known love before. Didn't know how to love anybody. Didn't even know what love really was before I got into the word. I'm not talking about going to church, because the church that God is coming back for is not a building now.
Amen.
See, we got to be very clear about this. He's talking about you and I, my brothers and sisters. We are the church that he's coming back for without spot, blemish, nor wrinkle. Now, the church building was built by the hand of a man, a construction company, so it's not perfect. So we have to really get under the teaching, like in the book of Acts with the apostles, so we can be taught how to live the word of God, how to trust and obey and walk in faith, by faith.
Amen.
That's what God taught me. That's what he taught me. So if you love me, he said, keep my commandments by faith, trust, and obey. No compromising with the adversary. You can't talk to the devil. And if you feel with the Holy Spirit, the devil don't want to talk to you no way, because you're speaking what is written. He already done been there. He don't want to hear that. That's why he got kicked out. He don't want to hear what's right and true. So if anybody coming to you compromising what is written, you don't have to talk ugly to them. You don't have to talk bad to them. You don't even have to call them names. Just say, well, brother, thank you, and I'll continue to pray for you, because they need deliverance. Or they may be on a false doctrine, because once upon a time I was. And I'm not ashamed, because God told me, you got to go out here and tell these people what thou said the Lord, and what I came to planet Earth to do. I came to redeem Son of Man, not to lie to her. He came to tell us the truth and what it was going to take for us to enter into his secret place. And I will tell you what I found out. It's the road called the straight and narrow. So if you standing at the crossroad today, wondering which way to go, I would encourage you to choose the straight and narrow, because that's where your joy, your peace, your love, and your destiny rest. And it's going to cost you. You got to be you transformed. Walk away from everything that the world tries to present to you. All the Illuminati stuff, you get that stuff. But what about the great white day of judgment if our name does not appear in the Lamb Book of Life? That's scary. To me, that's scary. So I fear God. I trust and obey his word, my brothers and sisters. There's no other way to the promised land, to paradise, except through God's only beloved Son, Jesus Christ. He is the way, the truth, and the light. There is no other way. I don't care what no ministry,
come
no pastor tell you. You got to get in this word and see what thus said the Lord. And whatever, what I'm speaking to you now, you go in there and you get those scriptures and you meditate on them and you study that word until it becomes real to you. And you know what? You will begin to speak just what Jesus spoke. He said, I came to do the will of my Father, to say what he told me to say and to do what he said do. Anybody else, you're wasting your time trying to tell them something, because it's not going to work. And what Jesus has done, we all see the evidence of his healing power, the miracles. Look in the word. Look in God's face, and you will see all of that, and you see people around you now, right now, here and now, that God has healed totally. And they will tell you that, but they won't say God, because that ain't the relationship. But he heals and let his sun shine on the just as well as unjust. That's why you can't judge people who trying to live the word of God. Well, man, I don't believe that. Well, you need to get your relationship with God. So yeah, that's the only way you're going to be able to truly know how faith works. But he is a God of faith. And I say to you, and I'll say this again, being lukewarm and practicing hypocrisy, you're not impressing God. He said that you and I are the ones that cause Son of Man to blaspheme his name when we say God and we practice what the world practices. You inviting them to church, but you ain't showed them nothing about your life. What has your church did for you? Because you still doing what you've been doing all of your life. This is just real talk. This is the word of God.
Amen.
This is the word, my brothers and sisters. You cannot denounce this, because if you do, if you shut your ears, you're not shutting your ears to the pastor. You're shutting your ears to God. Why? Because it is written. It's his word. Glory be to God. I pray that you get this. You digest this and meditate on the word of God and seek his faith. Not a piece of him. God don't need weekend lovers.
Come on now.
He don't even need you. He need people who's going to walk with him in spirit and in truth every day of our life. You should wake up with a song in your heart. Whether you're an artist or not, you should be giving God all the glory every day. Not just on Sunday. That's man stuff. I'm talking about what is written. Holy is the Lamb. He never, ever changes. The promise that he have given predestined just for you, you can have it. You will have it if you do what he tell you to do. And what's that, Brother Sherman? Be obedient. Seek after obedience. You don't know what that means. I can help you with that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lord, I thank you for my brothers and sisters. Help them, Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Give them the strength that they need.
Hallelujah.
God, wherever they may be around the world. Amen. To yes. Overcome that in which trying to overtake them in the name of Jesus. Yes, my
in
God, my God.
Glory, glory.
My Lord, the man of God said so many words of power, released so many words of power in the life of God's people. Amen. He talked about, you know, being a doer of the word and not just a hearer only, so that you will not be deceived. The text tells us, if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, he's like a man observing his natural face in the mirror.
In the mirror. Amen. Thank you.
For he observes himself go away and immediately forget what kind of man he was.
Hallelujah.
My Jesus. My Jesus.
Glory, glory.
See, it is the word that is the word that created us. Amen.
Yes.
And that's why we got to partake in this word, because, you know, amen, glory to God, because it is who we are. You know, the powerful man of God, he said, look, I didn't know what love was. Amen. And he had, you know, we got the same story.
Amen.
I didn't know what love was, and you know, and until I came into a true, authentic relationship, amen. Our Lord and Savior is Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And it's when you learn what true love is, pure love, you'll lay down your life.
Hallelujah.
You'll no longer want to do the one night stands with God.
Yes.
But you want to make this thing 24/7. Amen. Worship as a lifestyle. And he began to talk about, you know, how you should be in your environment, transforming the environment by that in which you do. And I love it because, you know, he talked to those, you know, those ministers. Look, he said, look, you need to discipline yourself.
Hallelujah.
Apostle Paul said it something like this. I keep under my body and bring it to subjection.
Lest that by any means
which I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway.
Yeah, bless the Lord. Yes.
Mm. For you not to be a castaway, you got to discipline your body. You got to discipline your mind. And as you discipline your mind in truth, he's like, look, you got to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Because so as a man thinketh, so is he.
Amen.
So if the mind is renewed in the truth of God's word, your body going to conform. Your body is going to just follow your mind. And so, amen, we got to begin to be a people that, you know, we say we love God. And, you know, God said, I don't need lip service. He said, I need you to show me how you love me.
Hallelujah. Yes.
I need you Thank to show you. Me, amen, through your obedience. Amen. I really need you to show me that, you know, and he said some real, God said, look, God said, I don't even desire your sacrifices.
Yes. Hallelujah. Because
your sacrifices mean nothing to me.
That's right.
And see, so many people, because we've broken covenant, because we're not obeying God, and you're sacrificing after this sacrifice, and it is not even going before the Lord. Because you've been deceived.
Hallelujah.
It's not going before the Lord because God does not desire a contaminated sacrifice.
Yes, bless the Lord.
And it's contaminated because, amen, you're not in the will of God. You can't bring, amen, you cannot be unholy and come before a holy God.
Amen. Thank you.
We have to have, amen, brother, we have to live by this word of truth. We have to live by this word of truth. Amen. And we have to stop going around just intentionally sinning, intentionally having no intentions on doing right by God, but you're professing his name. And then he talked about what your judgment day is going to look like. You can gain the riches of the earth, but what happens to your soul if you compromise? If you're compromising, see, the thing about God, see, and sometimes, you know, the enemy have the people of God so confused that, you know, you'll say that God did it for you and you had to compromise for it. That ain't how God worked. That ain't how God worked.
That's not amen.
If you got to compromise the word of God, guess what? That is not the Lord. That is the enemy luring you, keeping you from obtaining the true promise. Amen. He'll set you up with a counterfeit situation and a counterfeit circumstance just so you can take the bite.
Just so that you
can take the bite. And it is no time. You just don't know what tomorrow holds. No, nobody know what tomorrow holds. And compromise is just not an option. It should not be an option for the believers. It should not be an option for those who love and confess the Lord.
Yeah. Amen.
For such a time as this, we got to go and clean up the house. Go and get the house clean. Amen. Through this word of truth. And it will only happen through relationship. And the man of God said, he said, look, learn your word. To study the word, because it is the word that's going to purify. It is the word, amen, that's going to heal. It is only by the word that you will be delivered. It is only by the word, amen, who is Jesus Christ himself, that you going to get in, because he is the truth, the way, and the life. Amen, Lord. It is no back door way in.
Hallelujah.
No one can get to the Father unless they go through the Son. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. So we got to get these lives, amen, our lifestyles in order, no matter what the world offer. What does it profit you to gain the world but lose your soul? He said, God got a plan. Amen. He said, God got a plan. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Even in the midst of the adversity, in the midst of being enticed, in the midst of the trials and the tribulation, in the midst of everything that comes up against you, God has a plan.
Glory.
He just needs for you to remain faithful so that his plan will be revealed, amen, in your life, so that you may behold the promise of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. As he desire, he desire for you, amen, of glory to God, to behold the promise.
Yeah.
But there are some conditions. And when we come back, we got to tell we got to take a break here in the church. But I'm telling you, my Lord, we're going to take a break right here in the church. But I'm telling you, go ahead and share this broadcast on your social media platforms. Because I'm telling you, my God, when we come back, we're going to deal with the conditions in the plan. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Everybody want to talk about the promise. Everybody want the benefits. Oh, my God. But there's some stuff that comes with. Amen. There's some condition that must be met in order for you to get the promise. In order for you, amen, to walk and live in the benefits. To my God. We're going to take a break right here in the church. We are in the church with none other than the powerful, amazing, anointed, appointed man of God, music producer, songwriter, Christian gospel recording artist, minister, my God, Willie Sherman. Yes. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Who project was released this February, amen, titled God Has a Plan, amen, in Jesus' name. We will be right back in the church. Glory, 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 glory be unto God in this place, in the majestic name of Jesus. Surely, surely, God has a plan for you and I.
Hallelujah.
My Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
To make you feel just right, God.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, my God. We bless God in this place that we know that He has a plan. Amen. Glory to God for you and for I. You know, I am just recalled in my memory. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. The book of Jeremiah, you know, that famous scripture that we just love. We love to quote. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And over in chapter 29 and verse 11, and he was talking about a time of captivity. Amen.
Yeah.
Glory to God. Thank you. He's talking about a time of captivity, amen, in which, amen, Israel was in. And he began to speak, amen, to the prophet, my God. And he just began to tell them that when their 70 years are completed out of exile, out of Babylon, I'm paraphrasing some things right here, amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. He said, I will come to you and fulfill my good promise to bring you back to this place. Amen. He's talking about the promised land. And then he get into our very, very famous quote, a scripture. Amen. Text, for I know the thoughts that I have or that I think toward you, said the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. My God. To give you an expected end. So we're just letting them know that in the midst of your captivity, in the midst of your adversity, while you're in exile, just know and understand that, amen, that this is not your final destination, that I'm going to bring you back to the place of promise. Amen. Glory to God. You're not going to be away from the place of promise all of your life. I'm going to bring you back from that dark place. I'm going to bring you back from, my God, from depression and from the anguish and from the disappointment and from the shame and from the embarrassment and from the hurt and from the abuse. I'm bringing you back from that place because they don't know the plans that I've declared for you. And see, I just believe that there's some people that's under the sound of our voices, that you're in the midst of a struggle, that you're in the midst of adversity. That's some things that are broken loose out out of your life. Oh my God. And it may seem like that it is the end, but we're here to tell you on tonight that it is not the end. It is not the end of a thing, because what God has planned for you, it is of good and not of evil. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. And even as you search him, when you go a little bit further down in that text, he said that you will come to me and you will call upon me and you will pray unto me and I will hearken unto you. I will hear that in which you are speaking unto me, and I'm going to bring you back from your place of captivity. I'm going to bring you back. I'm going to gather you from all the nations and the places in which you have been banished, saith the Lord. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, hallelujah. Yes. I think the psalmist said, I called on the Lord and he delivered me from all of my fears, or he delivered me from all of my troubles. Oh my God, God has a plan. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My God, it's two things I definitely want to deal with, amen, in this particular segment on tonight. Amen. We're going to definitely deal with the condition, amen, of the promise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. So that we will understand that surely, amen, we have to meet our portion of the conditions so that we can dwell, so that we may stay in the promise, amen, of the Lord, that in which God has declared for our life. So we're going to deal with that first. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And we're going to come back. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And we're going to come and just deal with, oh my God, my God, my God, my God, just being one that will humble thyself under the hand of God so that he may lift you up, so that he may lift you up. My God, my God. Hallelujah. My God. let's talk about this. I am just on fire tonight, Minister Sherman. Oh, bless my God. I'm telling you, the plan that God has for our lives. Amen. Glory to God. And we know that, you know, in the plan that he has for us. So let's talk about this, you know, the conditions, because many a times, you know, out here in the society in which we live in right now, I just believe the reason why we are seeing sin run so rapidly in the land in these days is because, you know, people are preaching and ministering, you know, half truth. They tell them you can obtain the promise and still do anything else you want to do. You know, they forget to mention that there's some benefits. I'm sorry, that there's some conditions that they must meet in order for them to, amen, obtain, amen, glory to God, the promises of God. So let's just talk about that for a little bit here, dynamic man of God.
Yes, yes. Well, those conditions that we must meet in order to inherit the promise, the plan that God has for our lives, those conditions must be met. There's no way around them. There's no way through it. And can't nobody redeem you from them. You got to go through that. And it's not even for us. We are the churches without walls. So in order for us to be a light in darkness, in the midst of darkness, we have to go through and deal with those conditions for the lost. We have to do things to have a word and the experience to know what that something, whatever that someone is going through, we got to know what that really looks like. And we got to speak it through and by way of the word of God. So our conditions is to strengthen us to be what God wanted us to be. Just like Jesus, he was a king and he had to go. He had conditions he had to conform to on planet Earth. That's just to empower us to be not just to speak a word, but to live it. So what we must do, my brothers and sisters, in order for us to be elevated by Almighty God, we must go from glory to glory. And to do that, we must pass the test. We must walk in those conditions with hope, not hopelessness, but hope, trusting by faith that God will redeem us all from whatever the conditions is, through and by way of our submission and commitment to Him, living the life of holiness and righteousness. I mean, that's the way we inherit the promise, because He said every promise that He hath spoken from His mouth, He always fulfilled. But the conditions must be completed first before they come, and they shall come. If we go to the book of Romans chapter 12, verse 1 says, therefore, I urge you, brethren, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. And says, this is your spiritual act of worship. Again, everything God has given to us through and by way of His word, through the prophets, it was a purpose. He had a purpose and a plan. God has a plan for every living mankind, save or lost, ready or not. He got a plan for you. But you got to get ready for this plan through and by way of first redemption. We got to be redeemed from what we think we should be, because what we think we should be and how we think we should be, that may not be what God has for any of us, and it's not. His plan for man is to worship Him and to go out and be a soul winner, to minister to the lost sheep who's out there in the world just doing whatever. God wants us to go out there to show His glory and His power to the lost, that they might be redeemed through and by way of the Spirit of God. And that's what we have to be connected to, the tree of life. And when we're connected to the tree of life, we can walk under the same anointing that Jesus did. The Bible says in the book of Matthew, we would do greater works than what He did. We can lay hands on the sick and they will recover. We can speak a word without touching anybody and it shall come to pass. That's what Jesus did. So if we understand the mystery of the gospel, because it is, and you got to be filled with the Spirit to understand the mystery. Jesus told the apostles, there are many things I want to speak to you, but I can't. Not in the spirit. He had to speak to them in parable. He said they wouldn't be able to comprehend. So that, just like us in our state of conditioning and going through our trials and tribulations, just remember that this, that's not even for you. It's for you, but it won't overtake you if you're in relationship and where you're supposed to be with God, walking in righteousness and holiness and seeking His faith. And if you're not there yet, you go to run to the mercy seat of Christ and ask God, I did. So what? How do I get to you? What am I supposed to do? I know what the words say, but I don't understand all of that. I told God that. I didn't tell my pastor. I told God, the only one that I know who can redeem me and set me free and break the chains and shackles that was holding me in bondage. Could nobody do that for me but God? Not from where I come from, because I couldn't hear Him. I didn't hear Him. And I'm just being real with you, my brothers and sisters. I want your name in the Lamb Book of Life.
Amen.
God don't need us in heaven singing. All of that's out. When you leave, He already got the holy angels up there singing. So don't go up there talking about no record deal now, because He don't need you up there singing.
Mm-hmm.
He needs you to use you right here to go out into the... and to the world to minister to the lost sheep that He has.
waiting for you, my brother, my sister, waiting for you, all the stuff that you've experienced and the conditions that you had to go through to get there. He wants you to go out there and share that with them, the lost. All that other stuff yesterday, you ain't got to even go there because it don't glorify God. So don't be angry when you go through the conditions. Count it all joy, my friend. Count it all joy that God chose you to be used for his glory. That's what I do. When it don't look like it, this is not supposed to be happening. The devil is a liar. It's supposed to happen. To build me up and strengthen me so that I will be able to help someone else.
Come on now.
That don't know what you know. That don't have a relationship with God besides going to church and the Bible study. They hear, but they don't do. And there's nobody out there telling them the truth. They're not preaching the word of God. They're preaching religion. Well, I can truly tell you this, my brothers and my sisters. Religion won't get you into heaven.
Amen.
It will not get your name and my name in the Lamb Book of Life. Jesus is the only way. And then the conditions, you got to pass that till you got to go through it and count it all joy and say, Lord, for you I live and for you I die. And I know that's hard for some people who's here listening today. But guess what? That's the word. It is written. And I've said this before and I will repeat it because somebody needs to hear this. They that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Nothing else works.
Amen. Amen. He's absolutely right. Oh, my God. He's absolutely right. He just said so many different things, and I'm just going to, I'm going to grab that second half of, you know, when he talked about being that living sacrifice, holy and acceptable, a sacrifice that's holy and acceptable unto the Lord, you know, which is our true and proper worship. And then it said, look, do not conform. So, you know, amen, conform to the patterns of the world. And so we have to,
yeah.
He said, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind that you will be able to test and approve what God's will is.
Hallelujah.
Amen. His yeah. good, pleasing, and perfect will. And so we're
perfect
not
will.
To look like the world. We're not to, amen, glory to God, be clothed as the world when people see us because we are a set apart people. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We have been set apart, amen, to live holy, to live, amen, upright before mankind, to live righteous, to display and exemplify, amen, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in the earth. And that's
amen.
Why this word is so absolutely so powerful that we must partake in it. We must partake in it so that even when things come up that want to, that it looked like the way that we should go, but it is something in a just not quite right, you'll be able to tell because you'll be able to, amen, identify with the word of God. And the word of God is going to expose every lie. It's going to expose everything that's counterfeit.
Yes.
It's going to expose everything that isn't of the true living God, and it's going to cause you to walk away from those things as well. You know, over in the book of Deuteronomy, it was talking about, it talked about, look, if you obey, he was talking about, look, if you obey the Lord and follow the commands in which I give you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations on the earth. And all these blessings will come upon you and accompany you if you obey the Lord your God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. Thank you,
amen.
Jesus. If
amen.
You obey him. Amen. And so we have to become, amen, obedient, but we got to know the word and understand the word. Amen. Glory to God. Through the revealing of the Holy Spirit, he talked about the mysteries. And so it is the Holy Spirit that lead us and guide us into all truths. Into all truths. Amen. And as he lead and guide us into all truth, glory to God, think we can be free in, amen, in the word of God. It said, look, you're going to know the truth. You're going to know the truth. And the truth's going to set you free. The truth is going to set you free. Amen. And we got to be free in this word of God. Remember, people of God, and I am, we are in one moment. Amen. I know we just been engaging in conversation, and amen. And those, a few of you guys are on the line. We're going to, amen. If you have a question or a comment, if you can just mash star six, and it's going to put you in the queue, and I will bring you forth. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But we're talking about, amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. God has a plan for you and I. We're talking about right now in this discussion about we have to be those who are obedient unto the Lord. We have to meet the conditions, amen, in order to live in the benefits. Amen. In order to live, amen, in the promise of God right here, right now. Amen. Glory to God. You know, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. We just bless the name of the true living God in this place, in the majestic name of Jesus. I'm going to see if there's a caller. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. You can just match star six and it'll bring you right on up in the queue. Amen. So we don't have a caller in the queue right now, and that is absolutely all right. Amen. Glory to God. You know, thank you, Jesus, because we're just talking about this meat of God's word and how we have to be obedient and meet those conditions. Amen. The conditions that allow us to position us to obtain and walk in the promise of blessings, of the healing, of the favor of God. Amen. In the name of Jesus, even in the anointing of God, we have to humble ourselves under the hand of God. It was something else that you said, a dynamic man of God. Because see, if we're going to reign with Christ, we got to suffer like Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And so even before we transition over into this part, I want to talk about. So let's talk about, you know, in the midst of that adversity, because I just believe in the midst of the adversity that God is doing something. Amen. I just believe that even when you said you was in that place and you was asking God, I think that there was some things and God said to you, look, I got a plan, you know, letting you know that he had a plan. But even in the midst of that adversity, I just that was a part of the plan. I just believe that there were some things that was taking place, amen, even in your life. So let's talk about what type of things take place in our lives in the midst of the adversity.
Wow, that's awesome. So many different things. He began to shape and mold us into who he wants us to be and what it is that he wants us to do for his kingdom. He have to break us down. We have to die in order to live. When I say die, we got to die in the spirit. We have to be redeemed from our fleshly mind. That comes by the renewing of your mind so that he can subscribe and write his word on the tablet of our heart. And it's a process. Yes, it is. And he just began to work on us to take away those things from us that separates us from him. Whatever those things are, most of us know what that is. It's called sin. He has to redeem us from that because he's raising us up, shaping and molding us to go out there to be a light to center man. So he have to just, in the state of adversity, and I would truly be honest with you, there was things that I used to do because of what I do. I really had a problem letting it go. You know, but God said, well, you can't bring that here.
Mm.
He said, no flesh and blood can tear in my sight. You got to get rid of that. And that, which I was enjoying, I do prison ministry as well, and I have to tell these gods, I'm going to raise you up to show men what a real man of integrity looks like. It's not about just having a bunch of money, nice cars, nice home, and all the clothes. That's, and the women, God is not impressed with that, man.
And the same thing goes for the women. We got to get in a place with God where we just surrender and submit our whole heart, mind, body, everything to him and say, Lord, everything that I do, I want you to be the king of my life. You must be in the equation because I don't know how to do it. I tried. This is what I told God. I've tried it on my own and nothing worked. It felt good, but it didn't do nothing.
Come on now.
And our hours of our pleasure moments, we do stuff that we already know is wrong. The scriptures say he who knows to do right and to do wrong is sin.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
If you know it's wrong, sometimes we won't even repent for it after the fact. We continue to practice that. I used to live that life. I know what I'm talking about. The devil cannot trick me with that trash no more. That filthy, filthy
Come
thing
on,
called
man.
Sin, he can't trick me no more. It's filthy, it's nasty. I could have lost my soul out there in that music world and not even been filled with the Holy Ghost if I would have stayed. So we have to understand the process of our conditioning. It's for us to be who God wants us to be, to grow us up, so that we may be able to stand when the enemy comes like a flood. Paul had to go back and minister to the churches of Corinth and all the mother churches.
Mm-hmm.
Then when you confess, God said you've been born again, you're not supposed to be doing that anymore. So in the state of all of that, the state of adversity and conditioning, all of that is for us to do what Jesus did, to come, go out into, to be a light unto the world and to help people, the rich, the poor, the middle class, everybody. It's not just for one group of people, it's for everybody, everybody on planet Earth. I don't care where they are or what they have. They want love. People want to be loved. They want to be somebody that, you know, people will honor, not all the crazy stuff. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the word that people will come to when they have problems going on in their marriage, with their children, with their finances. They want to be able to come to us without us judging and going out telling the church their business. They want to be able to and feel comfortable with speaking to me and say, man, you know what? I don't know how to deal with it. And I mean, go into details about their mm-hmm. situation. It's not mm-hmm. for you to go out there and tell the church or
Amen.
Preach about them. Jesus didn't do that.
He did not. That's called sinning.
He said, go and sin no more. Yeah. So, you know, that's not what a true, genuine Christian feel mm-hmm. what the Spirit is supposed to do. If you say you know God, then you need to keep his commandment and walk like he walked.
Amen.
Jesus didn't do that. That's gossiping. You shouldn't go tell somebody. If he mm-hmm. wanted the church to know, he would have told them himself.
Amen.
And he may have asked me not to say anything because that has happened to me. But I don't, you know, I know the words, so I can't. If you ask me, I say, well, you have to ask him, because if he wants you to know that, he would have
mm-hmm.
to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
So all of this is part of being a disciple of Christ. Our discipleship, that's got to be real. You got to be taught this word. You got to be taught how to walk in the Spirit. You just can't wait. Well, I'm going to walk in the Spirit today,
Mm-mm.
but at 6 o'clock tonight, you walking in the flesh. What spirit was you really walking in, my brother, my sister? Because God don't turn on and turn off like that.
Mm-hmm.
His word is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. And guess what? Will never change. His kingdom will never waste away. It will never vanish away. He's God every day, holy, righteous, and true, 24/7. Even when we turn away from him, he still loves us. How many people you know going to do that?
Amen.
Nobody can do what the Almighty God can do. Nobody and nothing, not even money. He owns the money too now. Remember
Amen.
That. That's his money. These are his homes we live in. These are his cars. And when we fail to obey his word, he give us 25, 30 more years to get to a place where we will walk in obedience, that which he called us to do when he put us down here on planet Earth, to obey and to worship him. That's what we're supposed to be doing. If we would have done that, if Adam and Eve would have not been bewitched by the devil, I believe, according to the scripture, we would have lived paradise right here on earth. Mm-hmm. But we was cursed. Anytime you disobey God and you refuse to repent, even if you repent, the consequences still stand. You got to pay. So I would say to all of my listening, everybody that listened today to this broadcast, turn away. Conform not any longer to the pattern of the world, but be ye transformed. Then you will be able to test, Apostle said this earlier, and approve what God's will is in his good, pleasing, and perfect will. He has a plan for your life, my brother, my sister. God got a great plan for your life. And you will never see the manifestation of his plan if you continue life in the fast lane. Listen to me very carefully. If you want God, you can have him. There is no excuse. All that calls you is a submission. And after that, now you got to go through all the conditions and all of the state of adversity so he can build you up to show you who he is. Because when we read it in the Bible, most of us don't believe it.
Amen. You know, as you was talking, just so many different things just came to my mind. And so I want to come here first, just in the event that there's some people out there. Amen. Because, in this season, in this time, they're calling things that are holy. They're calling wrong, right, and right, wrong. And so I just want to help some of us out tonight, in the event that you just don't know what sin is. I just want to help us out in the text. Amen. Glory to God. See, the word of God says this in Galatians chapter 5. It said, the acts of the flesh are obvious: sexual immorality, impurity and debauchery, idolatry and witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealous, fits of rage, selfish ambitions, dissension, fractions, and envy, drunkenness, orgies, and the alike. He said, I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom, of God. And so when we're living these type of lifestyles, we will not inherit the kingdom of God whatsoever. It hinder us, amen, from inheriting the kingdom of God. And so, so we got to understand that we cannot live these type of ways or any way that we desire to do and think that we're going to inherit the kingdom of God. It is not so whatsoever. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And then he also tells us, look, you got to put away. He said, put away. Rid yourself of all malice and deceitfulness, hypocrisy, envy, and slander, and of every kind that we have to rid ourselves of these things, because these things causes us to sin against God. They cause us, amen, to sin against God. And then, over in the book of Revelation, it talks about, it was talking about how, those that have washed their robes, blessed are those who wash their robes Amen. For they would have the right of the tree of life, and that they may enter the city by its gate. He said, but look, but on the outside are the dogs, the sorcerers, the sexual morals, the murderers, the idolaters, and everyone who loves and practices false. Good. Amen. They just not entering in. It's just not going to enter in. And it doesn't matter, you know, what they say and what they and what has been told. Amen. We got to walk the truth of this God, of the word of God, and we got to walk it out. We just can't live any type of way and think we're going to get in. And that's why, you know, you don't want to build that part of what they said. Well, I prophesied in your name and I cast out demons in your name. And he said, you workers of iniquities, I never knew you.
I know you not.
Yeah, right? And so, you know, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. I mean, the gifts are without repentance, and we got so many people walking around here and going around, you know, you're moving and operating in your gift, but you ain't submitted.
Yes.
You ain't submitted, and we got to begin to be submitted unto God. That's what we got to humble ourselves under his mighty hand. He'll do the exaltation as you humble yourself under his hand. And when he exalt you, when he move in your life and he take you, amen, to the places that he desire for you to take you, ain't nobody going to be able to stop you. Ain't nobody going to be able to hinder you from getting into places and doing the things that he has called forth in your life. That's why you ain't got to compromise, because when God say yes, no man can say no. Even when they want to say no, they can't say no. Why? Because, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. When you're moving and you're being obedient unto the word of the Lord, his word is going to perform in your life. It's going to prosper. It's going to move and operate in the way in which he has sent it. Amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. In the way he sent it, not our ways. Amen, because his thoughts are higher than ours, right? His ways are so much higher than ours, right? Amen.
Yeah.
Glory to God, thank you, Jesus. And so we got to come into the alignment with the word of God. We got to come into the alignment in the mind of God, because God wants us to begin to for us to walk in the thoughts. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
You know, the
yes.
thoughts in the book of Jeremiah, the thoughts in which he had toward us. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. And that
Thank
comes
you,
with
Lord.
A submitted life, a submitted life, a sold out life. Amen. Unto the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. That's why I said, look, if my people who are called by my name will humble
Hallelujah.
Themselves and pray and just seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, turn from the sin. He said, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin. Amen. And will heal their land. Will heal
Lord.
The land. Amen. Glory to God. You know, thank
Lord.
You, Jesus. Hallelujah. And so we got to come into this place, people of God, where we are, we could become committed to God. We gotta be sold out to God. We're committed to man more than we're committed to God.
Hallelujah.
And because we are committed to man, we're following the traditions of man, we're following the word of man, and we're nullifying the word of God, making it of no effect in our lives. And we're walking around with a form of godliness and denying the power of the true living God to move and operate in our life, to transform us, mind, body, and soul. Spirit, amen. Glory to God, into the true living God, where we would walk in the very image and likeness in which, amen, he has created us to be. Oh, yes, God has a plan. And the man of God, he talked about, look, he said, right there in the midst of the suffering, right there in the midst of the adversity, see, God is building some things. Your character is being built right there.
Amen. Amen.
Your character is being built. Your identity is being built right there in the midst of the adversity. You got to remember when we think about Daniel.
Yeah.
When they said, look, bow down to the idol. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. And he's like, no, I'm paraphrasing here. He would not bow down. He said, look, you can't pray with Daniel. It was like, you can pray to no other God. Amen. And he was like, no. He went up to that room and he prayed, still them three times to the true living God. And so when he was found out and when they snitched on him or whatever, they threw him in the lion's den because he still refused to pray and bow down to any false idols, any false gods. And he found himself in the lion's den, but even in the midst, God came and sent the angel. Amen. And allowed the and the lion's mouth, amen, did not touch him, did not devour him, shut their mouths. They was at peace with Daniel. The lions was at peace with Daniel. But what I love about it, when the king, when they came and they pulled Daniel out of that lion's den, he said, look, nobody can speak against, amen, the God of Daniel.
Yes, yes. Amen. Amen.
They could nobody speak against the God of Daniel. Why? Because he didn't compromise. And so now here's the king who wanted the people to bow down to him and to worship him. We got him now saying nobody can speak against, amen, the God of Daniel. Amen. Glory to God. No, amen. And he's putting a decree out in the land. Why? Because Daniel did not compromise. And I just believe, people, God, we begin to stand up for truth and not compromise. Stop bowing down to the idols. Stop bowing down, amen. I'm going to God, thank you, Jesus, to those in the different industries and things of that nature. Thank you, amen, so that a door can open for you, because that's another form of idol worshiping.
Amen. Amen.
See, he said he'll open doors that no man can shut. Hallelujah.
No man.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God.
Lord.
Amen. Glory to God. He'll shut doors that no man can open. And you got to just trust him at his word. And believe in what it is that he has spoken into your life. And stand fast and be unmovable and unshakable. Become that tree that is planted. That is planted by the river, that even when the heat comes or the storm comes, you do not wither. Your leaves don't wither. Guess what?
Yeah.
But you still prosper. But you still prosper. My God, in the name of Jesus. That's why we got to get this word and meditate on it day in and day out. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. So that we won't sin against him. So we won't compromise against him. You know, no matter what. No matter what. Amen. Beholding onto his truth and obtaining the promise of his very word. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. My God. Glory. Glory. God. You know what? Amen. Oh, my. This word of truth. Amen. Glory to God. We talked about humility. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We did. That did run in our conversation as well on tonight as well. But I want to make sure before we leave this platform, we have a little bit more time. If there anybody on the line who would like to come in with a question, a prayer request, or a comment, you can just hit *6 and it'll bring you up in the queue. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But while we're waiting, Minister Sharman, can you let the people know where to pick up your project from? How can they and how they can get in contact with you?
Okay, to contact me, I'll give you my personal info. You can go to my website, which is www.wshermanmusic.com, and they have a link on there. You can go sample music. You can leave comments. You can buy CDs, of anything of that sort for his ministry. You can get it. Scriptures are there as well all the time. And then you would get the manager number as well if you wanted to go, didn't want to talk to me for bookings or something like that, for any events that you might be having, and they will instruct you about how all of that happens. And also, my music is in all of the music outlets on the internet. So Apple's, Google Play, it's everywhere. You can go to all of the online music stores and purchase the song that's out too. Song entitled God Has a Plan. You can purchase that there as well.
Amen. Glory to God. Thank you. Was there anything else, Minister Sermon, that we did not discuss when God was just ministering to you, amen, about this project, and to let you know to go out and encourage the people around the world to know the plan, to understand the plan, amen, that to know that God had a plan for them? Is there anything else that you want to minister unto the people of God to release, amen, from the word of God?
I would say to my brothers and sisters, I go to the book of Psalms 103, and I would like to just read a couple of these verses.
Amen.
That says, verse 1 says, "Praise the Lord, O my soul. All my inmost being, praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your sins and heal all your diseases, who redeem your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfy your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles." That's part of his plan for your life. God got a plan for you, my sister, my brothers, that you are not even aware of right now because of what you're doing and where you are. When you come in an intimate relationship with him, the plan shall be revealed. I want you to get this. I want you to think about this. I want you to meditate on this. I want you to seek God's face. And after you do that, and when you do that, God will reveal his purpose, his plan specifically that he has predestined just for you. He would allow you to walk into it. I encourage you to seek his face, to listen to his voice. He will take away all of the heartache and pain. His plan is for you to walk in his agape love, to do that which he is calling you to do, to speak life into the walking dead, to speak life. What we must do in order to embrace the plan of God that he has for our life, because he gave all of us a vision. If it was not so, he wouldn't have never said in the book of Malachi, "Without a vision, the peoples perish." So he gave all of us a vision. Now it's just up to you and I to seek God's face, to get the revelation to what it is, that how to do it and what it is. He's already gave you the gifts and the ability. All you need now is the Holy Spirit, so he can order your steps into that place that you have hope of going, but you don't want to do what you got to do to get there. It's going to cost you the condition, the trials and tribulation. You got to do that. That's part of the test. That's part of the test. So I encourage you to seek his face like you never done before, so that the plan that he has for your life, my brother, my sister, your life, that you will walk into it, not 200 years from now, but in this season of your life. Get it together and watch God. He's everything that you and I need, everything. Hallelujah.
Amen. I just absolutely love it. Amen. Where the guy said, look, there is a vision. He said, God has, amen, a vision, a plan in that plan that God has for each and every last one of us, because God is so strategic in his plan. Amen. Where the guy said, there is a vision. And so even with that, he said, look, without the vision that the people perish, amen, word of God, thank you, Jesus. He also said, write the vision and make it plain.
Amen. That's right. Write it and make it plain. You need to look at it every day. Every day. Put it in the bathroom. You go to the bathroom and tape it to the mirror of the door and look at that vision every day. That's an act of faith, whether you know that or not. Because you see that vision, but you're not walking in it because you can't touch the destiny right now. But you trust in God in the state that you're in, believing by faith, you speak those things that are not as though what? They are. Trusting in God. Obedient, my friend. Obedient. And your gifts and your talents is where your blessings are. But God got to be king, and the king of your life. He got to be.
because he's the only one who can take you there. Now, if you try to take yourself there, so I don't need to hear that, brother. Well, you'll be back. You will be back, and you will hear it. Or he did give us a self-will, or you can stay in the state and condition you're in and just accept what it is. Don't complain. And then when things are not working, don't call on God. Call on whatever you serve. That's what he said in his word. On your bed, told me on your bed of affliction, if you can't call me on sunshiny days when it start raining, don't call me. You call the God whom you serve. I have to be real with people because God told me, I got to tell you the truth. Wherever I go, I speak the word. So we all have to come in a place with the Holy God of Israel where we don't teach nothing but the word. Have a great day and know this. God got you. He's waiting.
Amen.
For you. He would never forsake nor leave you. He's waiting for you to come to him. He's been waiting a long time, and some of you can testify that you know he has.
Amen.
So why not just today? So, Lord, you don't have to tell anybody. You just go into your prayer closet and bow down, humble yourself to Almighty God at the mercy seat and repent. So God can use you. He's got a plan for your life. He has a specific plan just for you. I can't tell you what that plan is, but he had a plan for your life. He has a plan for every living mankind life. Ready or not, save or lost, God got a plan for your life. And the only way that you're going to inherit that plan, you got to do what Daniel did. You got to do it. Now you put me in a cage with a lion, the king of the jungle, and he became my pillow. God caused him to become my pillow. I rest my head upon him. But you thought he was gonna kill me. When you're connected to the tree of life, the devil can't touch you. You need to know that. But yeah. Now if you're already in his camp, you can't cast out demons, and you already know why. Well, for those that don't know, because you're a demon, you are operating in that same wicked, evil, rebellious spirit towards God. So God got to clean you up, my brother, my sister. You got to be polished spiritually so that God can reveal the plan that he has for your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you all, and I pray that somebody got a word today that they was waiting for. The apostles have given you everything that God told her to give unto you. Now it's up to you to do what she said do according to the word of God. Now you got to do what the word say do. Not just talk it, but to demonstrate it in your life. That's the only way you're going to know that it works. I bless and speak life upon every ear that hear and heard this word. And those that don't understand, I pray that God will embrace you as always, put you before a shepherd of his house who's preached the gospel, that he will bring you the wisdom and the knowledge and the mystery of the word of God, because it is real. The scripture says every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord of lords and King of kings. Believe it or not, it is written. So this is your day. This is the hour God has predestined to you to connect. To connect.
Amen.
To the tree of life.
Yes,
my God. I speak life into every ear that can hear my voice today through and by way of the Holy Spirit to turn away from whatsoever separates you from God. God bless
yes,
you.
Yes, Lord.
And I pray that you be redeemed so God can use you for his glory in the name of Jesus.
Amen. 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 Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And all I'm going to say behind that is this. Amen. Many other plans, amen, of a man's heart, but it is God's purpose that shall prevail. And we're just declaring that the purpose of God shall prevail over your very life. We have had an absolutely powerful, amazing time here in the church. Amen. It has just been absolutely wonderful as we've just been discussing. God has a plan. Amen. For you and I. We have been in the studio with none other than Christian and gospel recording artist, music producer, and songwriter, Minister Willie Sherman. Absolutely powerful, anointed man of God. You guys have, amen, you have been giving the information on how to contact him, how to reach out to him, how to, amen, get a hold of his music, what it is that God has placed on the inside of him, how to get in contact with his, manager and things of that nature, to have him to come and minister, amen, unto you or an event that you guys are having and things of that nature, this word of truth. I'm just telling you, my God, it has been a powerful time in the church. And we just bless God and we're just believing, even as the man of God prayed, amen, a moment ago, just touching and agreeing that, amen, that you received everything that you needed on tonight in the church, amen, in the majestic name of Jesus, and that your heart and your mind was touched, amen, and you would go before our Heavenly Father, amen, glory to God, and get it right and get it in line with him, amen, because you know that he has a plan, that the day is the day that you just say, not my will, my God, but let your will be done in my life in the majestic name of Jesus. We thank you for joining us in the church, and we look forward to being with you next Monday night at 6 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time, right here in the church. And we're going to go in the love, joy, peace, favor, and anointing of our most holy Savior, who is none other than Jesus Christ. And it is in his most holy and majestic name that we have convened in the church. Amen, amen, and amen. To God be the absolute glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen, amen, and amen. Glory, 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 glory be unto God in this place. And remember that, yes, he definitely has a plan, amen, for you and for I, in Jesus' name, my God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless you, dynamic man of God, for such, amen.